So I thank him for all the efforts. May all mentor contribute to you.
Amen.
And my brothers have been speaking all along on the unity of Islam. Unity is what we are losing in Islam. And what can bring about unity in Islam? My brother here, Brother Daoud, has spoken a lot about our achievement in the past, what unity has brought us in the past. And when Dr. Zakari had to speaking to, he was able to give us an analysis, which is very, very important. And as a matter of fact, I would like to have that report before I go today. If he will give it to me anyway.
Inshallah.
Thank you very much.
This is for all.
Yes. Because the issue here is, it concerns me, it concerns you. Muslims can speak a lot of grammar. They can speak a lot of Arabic.
Allah. And English.
And English.
Yes.
But when it comes to applications of Islam, they are nowhere to be found.
Subhanallah.
In the past, during the era of Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is a good example. We have to look at the way they behaved that day, that time. The problem we are having in Islam today is like in Nigeria. I was talking to one of my brothers who is right here. Is that we have Islam in Nigeria quite right, but we don't have Muslims.
Allahu Akbar. In the whole world.
Yes, we don't have, because the problem is, when you have Quran and you have Hadith, what are you looking for in the world again?
Allahu Akbar.
You have gotten everything you want in your life. But I look at it. Let me ask myself, do I love my other Muslims? There's no love between us. When there's no love, the love is lost. When the love is lost, you can never get anything. Our Muslim leaders from the SCIA, what they call them, anything, I can face them one-on-one. They only face their family and their family alone. Their only struggle for recognition, fame, all over. But is that what Islam preaches? When we pray, we are praying in the mosque, we will stand side by side, Suda to Suda. For us to recognize ourselves, for us to know our identity, for us to love ourselves, for us to know that, okay, this man is not as rich as I am. I have to assist him. Without even he asking for it. How many of these people have you assisted among yourselves? You pass through a mosque, they needed assistance. You are having millions of naira in accounts. How much of it have you donated to that mosque? Look, when you look at the number of people that EFCC are chasing all around today, Muslims are too many. Muslims, from Dasuki to anything you can think of in this world, they are all, majority of them are Muslims. Not like what my brother said in Libya in 2002. They have 92% literate. Today, what we are today. And they have the second best in fasting in the world. What do we have today? They have succeeded in winning Libya. And they have succeeded in winning Nigeria as well. And the next, if guys don't take care in the next 5 years, Muslims will be begging other people. If guys don't take care, if we fail in a bid to come together and work as a force, don't start looking for somebody's faults. We are in the habit of looking for somebody's mistakes, so that you capitalize on that, so that you can climb up. Why is it like that? Let there be love. Let us decide among us, within ourselves, that from today, I will be my brother's keeper. I will love my brothers. I will love my sisters. And to be well with all of us. That thing that is missing in us is love. When you see a Muslim on the road needing assistance, please step behind and help. When you are moving on the road, they say if you see any sharp object on the road, pick it. Our Muslim scholar, when they are moving, they will pick it. But when they see their Muslim brother trying to enter into a ditch, they will allow him to enter. Now, how do you correlate it? My brother, you know, you, they want to see you? Do I want them to see? Do you want people to see him that he's speaking that type of debt with that big rope and long beards on the road? Oh, this man must be a Muslim, but within himself, is he a Muslim? My brother, you don't need to be to have long beard before we see the exemplary way of life in you. I want us to think, our mothers, the thing starts from you. Give your children at home better education. Let your children know the way to behave as Muslims. When they are doing things that is not in consonant with Islam, please, for God's sake, correct them, because brothers are not around. They are always out there looking for money. And when our mothers lose their role as mothers, what is left behind? Nothing. So may all my children are going to gather the heart. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wassalamu ala mursalin.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. That should be prayed by our mothers in Islam. Because one of the quotations brought by our first speaker is kullukum ra'in, if I'm not mistaken, wa kullukum mas'ula. Every one of you is a caretaker. Even among, if you move further, you can see something like al-mar'atu ra'iyatun fi bayti zawjiha. Okay, inshallah, we are giving room to one of our royal fathers here before he leaves. Inshallah, he has something to say. We are very much in need of his words of advice. Walitfadal mashkura.
Min ash-shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Assalamu alaikum. I am the one standing here, chief of Kagini. I don't need to leave here early like this, but I have emergency at hospital. So I only want to pray for our lecturers and the Malam who organized this program. This program that is organized today is not that he's the richest man in this AG or in the world within here. No. But God have made him to do this occasion today here, to make our brothers and sisters to know what is Islam. Because we have been missing a lot of road. A lot of road we are missing. Because if you always pray and remember your Allah, Allah will remember you. But today, our lecturer have said a lot, which I don't need to revise back. It is what is going on now. You can see somebody, a Muslim, creating where to make money. And that money is not in Islamic way. And you can see his brother crying of 10 naira. But you told my brother, I even slept yesterday, I did not eat. It's a pity. So this unity is what we want. Our father said, whenever you want to drink water, you add your hand like this. It will take your water inside. But if your hands are open, you cannot carry water and even lift it to the mouth. So whenever we have unity and we know together, whatever in Islam, it will grow up. So I wish the lecturers to go back safely. May God will bless them. And the founder of this program, Malam, may God bless him. It is not that he's richer than everybody, as I say, but God have made him today make this lecture. If we have another brother getting means like this to call an occasion like this, we must be great and develop more than this. Thank you, God. We bless you all.
We are still on item number 7. Before we move back.
So let us know that our Quran is there for us to follow, and the Hadith of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Once you follow those two, you have no problem in life. But as the first speaker said, that where's your Quran? Where's my Quran? Some don't read Quran except during Ramadan. After Ramadan, it goes under the bed. So how will you contemplate about it? How? We don't know the Quran, we don't know the Hadith. There are some issues we have with some other people, that shaking a woman that's not a muharram is haram. They say no, they'll tell you in normal amal bin niyat. The Hadith that you don't know how the Hadith come about, he will explain it for you. So where is our Islam? Where are the Muslims? So anything we want to do, we should go back to Quran and Hadith. So and lastly, everyone as a Muslim should play his role. The women play your role, the men play your role, if you want a good community. The issue also that there should be gender equality, that's the Western life. And if we Muslims follow that, we have a problem, because there's a role that everybody can play in this life. for us to make our Islam complete. So by the time the women are coming to compete for the men, with the men in all activities, okay, who will be at home to train our children? There is time for everything. We can plan our lives and even do our work if we want. So may Allah, the world organizers, thank people for their efforts. I wish that we have what they said. May Allah give us the chance, ability to work what we have said. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum. I just want to respond to the first contribution about Islam, that we do not, there are no Muslims. That's what we are trying to say, that we don't practice Islam the way we are supposed to practice. As part of this paper, there is a submission that I made there, trying to look at somebody's work on what is happening now. I was in US. I visited the Muslim centers. I saw Muslims. I saw real Muslims. I saw real Muslim. My secondary and university education, I did it in Arab world. I read Arabic and Islamic education. For me, to now say I saw Muslims elsewhere, then that gives a very big question mark. Over there, there is Islam. In the West, there is Islam. Somebody was trying to say that we are trying to copy the West. If we copy the West, we'll be better Muslims. But we don't copy the West. We copy the riffraff of the West, the thugs, the hooligans. Go to Surah Al-Ma'idah, Ayat 54. There Allah says that if we refuse to do what we are doing now, I mean what we are supposed to do, if we insist on it, he will do what? He will raise other people better than us, that they will love him, and they will be doing exactly what he wants us to do. Some ulama believe that it is happening now, that the next generation of Muslims, that we were born Muslim, if care is not taken, we will lose Islam. And those people in America and in Europe, that is where Islam will now be established. In what they call it, in a response to this ayah. So we have to be very careful, because every other thing, like my brother said the other time, every other thing that our forefathers were doing is what they are doing now. Scientifically, educationally, now they are coming to religion. And you continue to say West, 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 Europe, Europe, Europe. We will continue to be saying like that, and before you know it, you will have to go there and learn about Islam. One of the ulama al-Azhar went to America. He said, "Ra'aytu fi gharb Islam, wala mara muslimin, wa fi mash muslimun lam ara Islam." I went to America, to the West. I saw Islam, but at home in Egypt, I saw Muslims, I did not see Islam. Because Islam is not just the five, not the fundamental foundation. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Buniyal Islam ala khams." When you build a house on five things, what about the remaining of the house? We forget about the remaining, we concentrate hypocritically. Not even really on the five foundations. Because if we practice the five foundations very well, it will give us the remaining of the building. The real teachings of that five foundations, if we follow it, not just for riyah, just to show off, it's time for prayer. That we'll be praying. traveling. Everybody says salah, salah, salah. Do we stop? They will pray and leave. As we finish praying, the same person that you pray with, when you see what he's doing, you'll be wondering, ah, what is happening? So, my fellow Muslims, we have a task in our hand. If our children, because we at least we are having 20%, 10% now. If our children should go 0%, and Allah now bring to forth, because he said in, I think in Surah Al-Imran, he said, لِكُلِّ نَبَئٍ مُسْتَقَرٍ. For everything that Allah said in this Quran is going to come to pass. If this one we allow it to come to pass in this way, that the center of Islam is now the West, and we are zero. On the day of Qiyamah, we have questions to answer. Wassalamu alaikum.
Alhamdulillah, Jazakumullah khair for this contribution. Now over to our Imam.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alhamdulillah,
we've had all the explanation people has given. And now start thinking and see what is the problem we have right away with us now. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I did not create men and jinn except for my worship. And that's what brought us to this life. But what are we doing? And before then, when the Rasulullah was said, the first thing was asked, people have announced here, that he was asked to read so that we can understand what the religion is all about. And what Allah says to us in the Holy Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا. Protect yourself and your family from hellfire. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran. Now, look at the example of what is happening in the society now. If you see the going men, the going people, check them and see. Count about 100 out of them. Bring out a non-Muslim out of them. Bring two, you see. We're not together, but you can see what we're saying. Bring two a non-Muslim out of them and see. And this ayah, Allah revealed this ayah to Muslims. What is happening? What's happening? Go to the office, you see a blind man, a non-Muslim, he's been employed. A cripple, somebody look at us, he's walking, he's been employed. He went to school to learn all these things. But what of Muslims? Where have you been at? What's our problem? If this verse, the Quran, is not revealed to us, I will not read the Quran, or just to have it for decoration, either in the car or in our houses. We don't read anything about it. If I was and Rasulullah is telling us, "Kullukum ra'in wa kullukum mas'ul 'an ra'iyati." All of you are shepherd and shall be asked over whatever is under you. So what are we saying? What are we thinking? Subhanallah. May Allah forgive us. Barakallahu fi Muhammad. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati 'amma yasifun. Wassalamu 'alal mursalin. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
So, Jazakumullah khairan for these contributions. Now to the item number 8, that's AOB, any other business on arising issues like the communique. Is it ready?
A'udhu billahi samin alim, mina shaitanir rajim, bismillah ar-rahman ar-rahim. Amma ba'd, assalamu alaikum. So I'm called unprepared to come and at least give a communique here. As a Muslim, anywhere you are called, one should not be scared. At least you have a word or two to say, at least. So among the communique I have here, there are about 4 points. One, we should love each other. Because loving each other has a great role to play in our life. Once you don't love each other, problem arises. You are going there, you are going this way, you are going that way. So how can you come together? And if you don't come together, how can you achieve your feat in life? You cannot achieve. So loving each other is of paramount importance, and there are many ideas that support that too. Then, seeking for correct knowledge. When we say knowledge, we mean what can move you close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as what? As preached by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Meaning knowledge, correct knowledge of Quran or Sunnah. Not a knowledge that will tell you
you read Salat al-Fati, you have a revolver than Quran. That's not a knowledge. Not a knowledge that will teach you to abuse the control of the Prophet. That's not knowledge. Not the knowledge that they will use Quran to spoil people's life. That is not knowledge. If you go to Talim Ta'alim, that before you go to any malam to learn, stay far away from the malam first of all and observe. Which type of malam is that person? Don't just rush to anybody. Which type of malam is that person? So if what he's teaching is according to Quran and Sunnah, then go to him. Otherwise, go away from him. Also, our children, don't just send your children to any malam to read. Okay. Don't send your children to any malam to read. Investigate the malam you are sending your children to before they bring you a akida that's against Islam. Also, we should assist each other in terms of needs. As I've been said, somebody is a millionaire, somebody is a billionaire, his next neighbor slept with hunger. Are we really Muslims? Where is the Islam? Where will it take all those words to? So we should learn to assist each other in terms of need, please. Women should also play their role in molding the children together with the men. As you know, the children are closer to their mother and they have a great role to play. In most civilized Muslim world, children don't go to primary school. Their mother is their primary school. So you can see that our mother have a great role to play. If we are not saying that mother should not work, but there should be a specific type of work that will do. The work that will not take them away from their family for a long time. In the morning, 7 o'clock, father is out, mother is out. Who is training the child? Who? The nanny and the houseboy? Well, has to be learned. Anyone that a nanny and houseboy, you left your child to their care, you two, you know what will happen. We have been hearing many cases. So may Allah make us to correct what we had here. May Allah make us not an iman. May Allah make our end to be a good one. And may Allah make our end to be a good one because not an iman. The organizers, may Allah reward them bountifully and give us Jannah too with them. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa atubu ilayka. Assalamu alaykum.
Ustaz Hamza Abdul Majid. Now, finally, we are going to the item number 9, which is suspension dua by an imam.
A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Assalamu alaykum. Today being 29 of May 2016, I'm very happy for this wonderful program that Dr. Rashid is trying to organize people here to hear the word of God and some few issues that we help our Muslim woman. I wouldn't stand here to bring the history of a doctor or to hear doctor, but our people say a respect is good to give a doctor whom is supposed. I cannot forget last 2 years ago, doctor has a program here, but when I came to that program on that day, I said something here, I don't know what I said, but I still remember. I said, Dr. Rashid, for some years I'm not doctor. We are more than 10 years. But the philosophy of doctor is somebody that I'm praying for him that not go even give him the president of this country. Yes, I said it that day. And don't be surprised, even to go and do anything. Oba or Sibanjo Abi, our vice president today. Is it in a pastor? Can everybody think that I can be a president of this country? But now look at it today. Through my research, are they still know that we have some people like doctor for this country? But I feel sad and disappointed that doctor can call this kind of gathering. Only few Muslims can able to attend this program. Last week, I cannot forget, I get program in my own village there, or I can call it lunch. We do a lunch, we build a madrasa in our community there. When I invited the doctor, Dr. Ken is one of our guest lecturer, but Dr. Keith said the same thing. He bring the issue of this unity. When doctor is talking for his own program or his speech that day, people are just shaking head like this. And likewise, as I came today, doctor is saying the same thing. Lack of this unity is bringing a lot of problems for this country. When the president will move them, let me tell you the truth. The 70% of poverty in this country is Muslim, if you don't know. Go to the north. If you go to the north, you say that what you go there and say is true. Why? What is the cause and what is the effect? So now, if I look at, somebody has already said something here, then if you look at the people that are EOC that are arresting today, most of them they are Muslim. You can hardly that one Muslim have a trillion in other country, where some people they are suffering here. Secondly, you can hear religion differences. We supposed to come one and fight against Islam to turn our younger one so they can become another people tomorrow. That's number one. Number two, Islam tell you to do fasting. Anything that Quran says has reason. But before I go, I will ask a question on both of that fasting now. Now Ramadan is approaching. So now, if you are doing fasting, I think you can, that small hunger that if you feel a small hunger, you have to remember that yes, poor they are suffering for this country. And I think that is the reason of doing that fasting. But up to today, we cannot help our poor, which is very wrong. And also, what people say here, you taught my mind in terms of this education. So, time to reach when we're supposed to stop playing all this gamble, all this rubbish. Just don't go near to our scholar. If you ask me to see me like this sometime in the morning, you will see me for the front of the scholar. I'll carry small bag, daddy. I told them made the treatment more small. It's not a shameful thing. There's no need in education. So what if we can still learn what of our children, what of our wife? And if we learn, we leave our wife behind, we'll never do anything. We have to teach them also. So doctor, may God bless you. For this wonderful program that you called today, now only God will bless you. Anything that is praying for this occasion, may God bring abundance. I cannot be able to say anything. May God bless you with your family. For my question, fasting don't come. So I still have question to ask so that the scholar will open her eye more. My question is, what is fasting? That is my question before I close my remark. Thank you very much. So and I want our scholar to answer me that question. Okay, first speaker, please.
I was able to say, we let him initiate and reject. As described by Islam, is hold your mouth from eating, drinking, anything of such, and talking unnecessarily. Okay? Keep your mouth away from all that. From morning time till evening. And stop sexuality in the afternoon time with your wife. But in the night, you can meet her. But in the daytime, in the afternoon time, keep off from her completely. And devote in worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any other question? Serki?
I think I want you to pardon us, please. Is it a question?
Wa assalamu alaikum. I want to formally commend the effort of the organizers and the staff as well. May Allah reward them abundantly. And may Allah strengthen them. And may Allah make us the listeners, the best listeners. And may Allah strengthen our wives and our mothers. If you observe this environment, it is purely, if not, one-man show. Resources have been put together to make us comfortable. The environment needs an assistant. I know there's no launching like Fisabilai on the agenda I was given. But I feel in an environment like this, even though it's a trail, we pass around to save civilian life. Probably if I don't have anything now, we make a commitment to take to the school authority so that they can use it for their interest. So I crave your indulgence to seek for feasibly like to assist this noble gesture. Though the scholars have done reasonably well, we cannot reward them, we cannot pay their salary. That has been the bone of contentions. It is not easy to bring our scholars together. It is never easy. But this scholar, if you are to pay their consultancy fee, if this is to be done in other places, just as they say, Sheraton, all these things, just what they packaged and they call it youth empowerment. By the time they collect for 5,000 minimally on each and every one of us, the scholar was my home. But in our own case, the reverse is the case. But we pray Allah will sustain them. They are going and coming. So for Allah's sake, whatever we have, we should drop it down. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum.
Who will go around to collect feasibility? Please, we are looking for feasibility for this institute, doing Center for Islamic Affairs. Center for Islamic Affairs is very much in need of financial assistance. Even moral assistance is also needed, but right now financial assistance is more needed. In cash and kind.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My own is just a contribution to what people have been saying since moral contribution. Okay, and I will direct my own contribution to the speakers. It has been that you are the one speaking to us, but I think it's time I personally speak to you. The chief of GIDA, he mentioned one thing the other time, that in the past 3 years, if someone tell you that a pastor will be a vice president in this country, you will be say, a pastor who's supposed to be in the mosque. The same thing goes to Islam too. And it is at this point I want to call